So here are all my parts for my boxes ready to get water locks on them. We have a nice mild winter day here in Texas, so I'm going to get outside in my metalworking area and do all this pre-finish work today. Like I said, I would much prefer to finish these drawers, the bulk of them, when they're laying flat and open like this, than to try to finish into corners and drawer bottoms, which is always a mess. Especially if you like to build the finish the way I do. You know, if you're just gonna baby it on and just barely put any on, well then, you know, it's probably fine, but I like to build it up. Here are the last two drawers that I need to glue up. So you can see that where I masked off for the finish. So here, I was able to get two coats on this yesterday on that nice winter day, but today the weather turned ugly and it's just above freezing right now, so I don't want to try to finish inside my shop because I would just stink this place up and I'd have to wear a respirator all day and I don't want to do that. So normally I would like to get a little bit more finish on than this, but this is going to have to do for now, and then I'll just come back in and when I'm sanding and finishing the outsides, I'll just reach inside and do these insides. But another really nice reason for having this pre-finished is as the glue squeezes out of the corners, the glue won't adhere to the finish. And so it's going to even be easier to peel off the glue from the inside corner of the drawer component. And so here are all my, there are all the other four drawers over by my heater. So I got them clamped. And the reason I clamp them end to end is just so those ends don't smile just a little bit. So once they set, you know, that clamp can come off. But the dovetails are actually just pressed together and they've got so much friction that they don't need to remain under clamp. It's just the ends. The top and bottom ends, just so they're not smiling. That just kind of always bugs me. And you know, maybe what it is that the wood moves a little bit after it's milled up, and you know, we got temperature changes and stuff. But the poplar is so easy just to pull it back into flatness again, and then the glue will hold it. And so here's my gluing setup over here. So let me get started here. I don't like cracking these, and a lot of times that it fits so tight, right here, that especially on this where you've got a small little ear there, that as you're pressing that down in there, you'll bust that ear off or make a big crack in the workpiece right here. And so what I do is I just come in really simply and just kind of pair with a chisel and just kind of pare those not out to the portion that you're going to see, but just on that part that's going to be hidden inside the joint, just so with that glue in there you don't get that piston effect where it's going to bust that corner out. See, that's all I'm talking about, is just paring that in there on these ends, just so you don't break those ends off where the wood is weaker out on those edges. But here in the middle, you don't have to mess with it. Or not on this one. So, you know, I'm just gonna pare this. And I'll do that on all four ends. Now before I glue these up, while I have an opportunity, while everything is free access, I take a piece of, you know, this is, in this case it's 180, because you know, this is not fine furniture. This is more commercial grade that I'm making these filing drawers out of. And so I just lightly scratch it just so it's ready for the next coat of water locks when I do reach down inside and wrap it. because it's just a lot easier to do it right now. It's gonna take no time to hit it like this, and just, I'm not talking about doing anything, but just making sure that there aren't little particles of sawdust embedded in my finish or little grains of pollen since I did it out in my open air area yesterday.